Hey there, my name is Andy O'Neill, and I help entrepreneurs like you add automation to their business. As I'm looking back over 2023, I can't believe it's already December. I'm recording this December 5th, 2023. I started using ChatGPT in November of 2022. So it's been about a year since I started using it. I'm using it daily, and I thought I might go through my top five make scenarios where I use ChatGPT and just show you some of the ways I'm using it. Okay, so this first scenario is how I automate my LinkedIn posting. And I have come to the point where I don't have time to write things myself, so I'm automating that. So what this does is it watches an RSS feed. In this case, we're watching the knack.com RSS feed. And I'm actually generating a post using ChatGPT. So I tell it to create a professional LinkedIn post from this Knack article, this Knack blog post. I go in and retrieve the image from that post and I schedule it in Buffer and I hard code my call to action. I also put the URL of the blog post. And so this is how I post Knack articles to LinkedIn. Number two, I'm using ChatGPT to extract information from unstructured data. So I am in a Slack community. And as people join this community, there's a channel called Introductions where people go in there and they say, hey, my name is, here's my LinkedIn profile link, here's a fun fact about me, and here's the kind of work I do. And it's just in a Slack post. So it's not in any kind of structured way at all that I can pull that information. I use this module for ChatGPT to get that LinkedIn profile. And I say, I want you to find the LinkedIn profile. Here's an example, and I give it mine as an example. So I get the LinkedIn profile, and then I'm asking it to get the full name of the person who is submitting the information about themselves. I have a prompt here that takes their information from the Slack channel, their introduction, their fun fact, that kind of thing, and it writes a introductory note that is personalized to them for LinkedIn. What I do is all of this gets added to Monday. So I have a Monday board where I can go through one by one and I connect with those people from this group. And I already have the link. I can click on the link to go directly to their profile and I can copy and paste that personalized note ChatGPT wrote for me, because it's always better to connect with people on LinkedIn if you write a personalized note and say how you know them and that kind of thing. Number three, what I'm doing here is I am taking an email that is received from my inbox, and I am summarizing the task with ChatGPT, simply summarize the text of this. I'm creating a title, and then I'm determining an urgency. So basically, I'm saying, determine if the tone of this email is urgent or standard. And so what's happening is then we're sending this over to Notion. So I have the name of the task. So I've gone from an email that needs to be done to a Notion task. So I have the name of the task. I have the status. Right here is the summary. And right here is the priority based on ChatGPT looking at the text of that email. This is a really cool one. Check out the webinar if you want to see this in detail. All right, this next one labels my emails based on the content of those emails. So this scenario is watching emails. And then it's assigning a label. So what I have here is I've defined and said, assign the label of sales if the email is from someone who works in sales, business development, or they're introducing themselves to me to sell something. Urgent, newsletters, Calendly, money, medical, client. I have predefined all of these labels for emails, and I've asked ChatGPT to read the email and put a label on this. And so what happens is it sets the label, and then I go over here and I update the label on that email. So I can really quickly look at the label on the email and say, oh, this is urgent. This is an invoice or a salesperson introducing themselves, trying to sell something to me. But you can check out the full video on this one. But this one's fun because it helps sort and organize my inbox. So this next one goes back to my second brain. I'm trying to put everything in Evernote so I don't have to remember everything. And so here's an example of that. I actually have a audio recorder app on my phone and I can open it up and dictate to it. I can just talk to it and it will record an MP3 file. And so what happens then on that app is it actually transfers that to Dropbox automatically. Once I'm done recording, it syncs it over to Dropbox. So this is going to watch the files, watch for new files. And I have a particular folder in Dropbox only for this purpose. It's going to download the file. And then what's going to happen is I'm actually using Whisper to transcribe that audio file. So turning it from audio to text. And then I am generating any questions or actions that need to happen. So I'm taking that transcript and asking it if there's any questions or any to-dos that need to happen from that item. I'm generating a name. I'm saying, look at this transcript and create a succinct and meaningful name for the note from this transcript. And then the next thing I'm doing is I'm saying, create 8 to 12 tags. So let's tag this with the content of that audio. And then I'm creating that Evernote note so that I have that there. So all I have to do is pull out my phone. If I have an idea or a thought, something I want to remember, I just pull out my phone and start talking, and it adds it to Evernote. I hope this video was fun and helpful for you. I hope it sparked some ideas about how you could use ChatGPT with Make. If you have any other ideas on how we could use that or how you're using that, please drop that in the comments. I love ideas and inspirations for future videos, and I would love to see how you are using ChatGPT with Make. As we turn a new year soon into 2024, the possibilities will just continue to grow. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.